Okay, I just wanted to share some tips about how to go from line bond structures to Newman projections, particularly when we've got stereochemistry in the molecule. So we often use Newman projections to show a molecule with stereochemistry or a particular conformation of a molecule where we're looking at the molecule from a different angle to when we draw a line bond or a zigzag structure. Okay, so I'm going to use this hexagonal grid template that I've made. It's a PDF file, so you can print it out and use it in paper form, or you can use it in an annotation app. So I use Windows PC. It's a Surface laptop with a stylus, and I use the Drawboard PDF app. There's lots of other possibilities, and on iPad you can use things like Notability, or there's a bunch of other apps that let you annotate PDF documents. So we're going to draw out a four carbon chain. So this is a butyl chain or butane, and we're going to have two chlorine groups that are coming up towards us, towards the viewer from this chain. So those are two chlorines, and we're going to have two hydrogens that are going away from us that I'll draw in blue. Okay, so what I've drawn here is the same as what's in this model. So we've got the plane of the paper is going through each of the four carbon atoms, and then the chlorines are coming towards you as the viewer, and the hydrogen atoms are going away. Okay, so what we want to do is convert that to a Newman projection. So we draw an equivalent sign. So this is just another way of drawing the same molecule. And a reminder that Newman projections are used when we're drawing conformations of molecules. And what I've drawn here is a staggered conformation, which is the most stable conformation for a molecule, or one of the most stable conformations. And so I want to draw this as a Newman projection. And for a Newman projection, we want to imagine that we've got our eye looking along the central carbon-carbon bond, so along this bond here, and that's this bond here. So if I twist the molecule around, now you can see you're looking down that bond, and everything that was up is now off to the right. So the two chlorines off to the right within this structure as we look along that carbon-carbon bond from that angle. Okay, so first thing to do with a Newman projection is to draw three lines that meet at a point, and they signify the three things attached to the front carbon atom, so this one here. Okay, so we're going to have a down methyl group. So this is the CH3 group that is down here. So we're going to draw something that goes down. And we can use the hexagonal grid to make this nice bond angles and to remind us to keep 120 degrees between each of the groups. And then we're going to have the group that's going up and to the right is the chlorine atom. So I'll draw that in green. And then up and to the left is going to be this hydrogen atom. So that's going to be blue. And then we've done all the substituents on this front carbon atom. So now for a Newman projection, the rule is the back carbon atom here is represented by a circle, and the circle's not as big as the bonds we've just drawn. And out of that circle come the bonds to that set of three substituents that are attached to it. Okay, so now where do we draw those? For an eclipsed conformation, we draw those in exactly the same places as the front bonds, but slightly offset because it's very hard to draw things that are completely overlapping. But for a staggered conformation, these now point towards these parts of the hexagonal grid. Okay, so we're going to have one bond going straight up, we're going to have one bond going down that way, and one bond going down that way there. And that's going to be these three groups. Okay, so I'll get rid of those circles. And now the group that is going straight up here is this methyl group. Okay, so this methyl group here is going up as we look at it from this direction. So there it is there. The chlorine is going off to the right. So we draw that chlorine atom in green, and the hydrogen is going off to the left. And so now we've got our Newman projection. Okay, so that's that particular example. Let's look at another example. Okay, so now we've got a different diastereomer of this 2,3-dichlorobutane. So let's draw out that. We've got a four carbon chain again. I'll draw in the methyl group straight away this time. Now, as we look at it, there's a plane going through the carbon atoms here, and coming out towards you on the left-hand side is a chlorine atom. So we've got, it's coming towards you, so it's going to be drawn up there, and we'll draw the hydrogens in blue again. But this time, the other chlorine atom is going away from you, so that's going to be a hashed bond to a chlorine atom, and a wedged bond to a hydrogen. So Newman projection time again. And what I'm going to do is do it from the opposite angle this time. So I'm going to look at it from this side over here, going up this way along that bond. Okay, so now we're looking this direction. So I'm going to turn the molecule like this. And it's a bit harder to see now because I have to tilt it up towards the camera for you to look at it properly. So now if I draw out that as a Newman projection, the front carbon here actually has the methyl group going up. So when I draw those three bonds, I'm going to have to start with an up CH3 group. And then the other two bonds are going like this. The one that's going down and to the left is to a hydrogen. So down and to the left is like that. And down and to the right is to this chlorine atom here. So that's over here. Okay, the back carbon atom is going to be a circle like this. And then if you look at it, we've got the methyl group is going downwards here. So that's pointing towards that part of the hexagonal grid. And then the other two bonds are pointing out in these directions. And we've got a chlorine atom up and to the left, like that. And a hydrogen atom that I'm holding onto over here is up and to the right. Okay, so that's up and to the right. And then we've got a Newman projection for this other diastereomer of that molecule. Okay, so hopefully you found that helpful. It's good to have a model. If you don't have a model, then I'm putting interactive models onto my website alongside with these videos. So go check them out and have a play around with them to try to get this good feeling for going between the 2D representation on paper and the 3D model of the actual molecule and the different ways to represent them from either line bond structures or Newman projections. Thanks a lot. Click the link above to subscribe and you'll be informed every time I put out a new organic chemistry video. Or click below this video to see interactive tutorials on my website, Organic Chemistry Explained.